That's not too bad, I guess. All right. So we had a project where I was working on patching my bivy. There was an accident and one of the other campers had a freak out and started smashing fire sparks everywhere. And because we have to respect people's mental health, my gear got damaged. Thankfully not the sleeping bag, just the bivy. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the tapes and see if we can do the alright guys, so we had a camper freak out and ruin our bivy. We had an attempt, we purchased some tapes previously. We had one that didn't work, and so I went and acquired two more. I got this Gorilla Permanent tape, it says, and it's sort of a blue color. And then I got this flex tape as seen on TV. So you can see there's a myriad of little holes everywhere. So I'm going to open this up and pull out the bivy, separate it from, see, patches everywhere already from the other tape. Well, so far they've held. We'll need this for right now. Okay. So that's a large piece of material. That's Tyvek. That's Tyvek, which has been which has been softened, mechanically softened through the machine. So I'd like to try some of this flex tape. I have the two brands. I got the flex tape and I got the Gorilla tape. So we can see which one here has a better chance of staying put. And I understand that this type of job is exactly the type of job that the flex tape likes to do. I don't even know how to open this. Sticky. Oh wow, look at that. Look at this, like it's a really bizarre material. Like, show it here. some really gooey and heavy. I like it. So we're just gonna look for holes. And we're just gonna cover them up. There's one there. So I'll mark them as I go. That we can monitor them for future reference. Bunch of them here. All right. Keep marking. And people ask, why can't you just get a fresh sheet of Tyvek? And the problem is that this one's been softened, so it doesn't have that super loud, crunchy, fresh Tyvek sound. This is not what I wanted to be doing with my waterproof bivy, but when somebody freaks out and goes all violent offender, what are you supposed to do? All right, so we'll keep marking these. And eventually, we will do the taping. So if you guys can see, I'm just marking these holes one by one. All right, starting to look good. Got most of them, some of them. Here's a rip that should get fixed. All right. So let's start with that rip I just found, because that's only going to get worse. Tape is super sticky. use this book to push on it. Or maybe not. Is there material missing from this gap? I think that this rip is worse than I thought. Get some of these other pieces going. We'll be all set. Let's see what happens if I just try to do some tiny patches. While covering the existing ones. Seems to be bonding quite well with the surface. Okay, so far so good. Here and here. Should mark those. This tape is so sticky, it's definitely giving the scissors trouble. Better keep this away from the bedding. Press that in, feels like it's never gonna come out. And 20 left to go. Alright, so I've done a little bit smaller squares. And do some of this on here. There's still so many holes, guys. guy. So I'm down to the last 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. I'm down to the last 20 holes now. So I've been patching this for a while. I've been using the flex tape. And I'm down to the last 25 or 30 holes that Adventures of D's got in my bivy. All right, there's so many here that I'm gonna do two with one. So I'm cutting them a little bit longer now. thing. And that is that. I'm just going to check here in case this was also ruined. All right, guys, looks like that's it. Ciao for now. So we got her all wrapped up, put away. We're gonna have to locate the stuff sack and go from there. All right, so. So I located the stuff sack for the bedroll, and we will see how this does. If it will fit in the stuff sack with also the Tyvek Bivy. Barely. What do you think? Is that a normal size sleeping bag?